go.
Thought the entrance was around back.
Friday night at the movies with Roger Edict. Snicker.
Oh, I left my Pete's and Pop over here.
Thank you. How are you folks tonight? We just heard a good joke and we're just laughing over right now. We're just going to review a few movies. Right, Roger?
Yes.
Well, first of all, we're going to review...
Well, what movie is that?
The first movie we're going to review is... Came from the Woods, Part 1, starring Tom Cooper and Tim Cooper, with cameo appearances by Bob Cooper. And in the other movie, we're going to review, what is it?
Raiders of the Lost Ark, starring Harrison Ford and Karen Allen.
Oh, I forgot, Friends. You're being honest, we're going to review that first. So, let's get that straight. And third, we're going to review, that great sequel to the first smash hit. It came from the woods. It came from the woods, Part 2. Another blockbuster movie. And our fourth movie, what are we going to review?
Ghost and Mr. Chicken.
Ghost and
starring
Mr. Chicken.
Knots.
Don Knotts. Yes. That ought to be very entertaining, too. We're going to review these movies. And our fourth movie... Fourth movie we're going to review... Well, Charles Dickens' great immortal classic, A Christmas Carol, starring Tom Cooper and Tim Cooper, with no cameo appearances.
And
that was a real funny joke.
And
that producer wouldn't tell us those goofy jokes before we come on, Roger.
And our,
What do you want, Roger?
What's our next movie?
You should know.
What number?
Number 5.
Yes, it's number 5. Six.
The movie Invitation.
The movie?
What
Invitation to Murder.
Invitation to Murder.
Starring Tom Cooper and Tim
Cooper. Tom Cooper and those guys are terrific actors. Let me tell you this right now. And we're going to review our Dog of the Week movie.
Tell me something.
Raiders of the... No, we've already...
Raiders of the Lost Ark would be the last... Gone with the Wind.
No, we're not going to
do that. We have it down here. No, we don't.
No, we don't.
We don't have a helmet.
Oh, it's taped over. Sorry, folks.
Let's see what our dog of the week. See what our dog of the week is.
Check out what our dog of the week movie is.
Gene.
I'm sorry. Gene. Sorry, Roger. I've been a little woozy. All that drinking. What is it, Roger?
Our dog of the week is Arsenic and Old Lace.
Arsenic and Old Lace. We're going to be back in... Why don't we just review our first movie right now?
What is our first movie?
Is it Raiders of the Lost Ark, Roger?
Yes, it is.
Is it? We have it?
Yes, we have it.
Yes, okay.
We're going
to go... I'm going to go to get it ready right now.
Movie lacks consistency.
Those are my lines.
It doesn't really give the audience a good plot.
That's what I got from the movie, Roger. It left no basis of... I mean, it kept you going in some spots. Then it dropped you and it flattened you.
Yeah.
It had no continuing interest.
Yes, that's what I say, too.
Harrison Ford, I thought he did a good job. Karen Allen, I don't know.
But
she was good.
She was lost.
In the movie. Yeah, she always seemed like she was a lost character.
Yeah.
That's what I figured. I think Saul had done a very nice job. John Rhys Davies, that is.
Yeah, John Rhys Davies. My voice just went back to normal.
Take it easy, that producer always tells those funny jokes. But, you know.
But you know,
I think, well, all in all,
yes,
I think Raiders was an average movie. That's all I think.
I wouldn't go see it again.
I'd maybe see it once. I could recommend you maybe see it once, people, but don't spend your money going 4 or 5 times, because it's a waste of, excuse me, of money. I think I'm going to
waste of time and money.
Mm-hmm. So, what do you give it, Roger?
I give it a thumbs down.
That makes thumbs in the middle. I think it's an average.
You gotta give it a thumbs down.
Well, okay.
You can't do this, Gene.
I can't straddle the fence. Okay. I give it a thumbs down. Raiders of the Lost Ark, let it be put on record that we both give it a thumbs down. Yeah. What's the next movie, Jack? Okay. Our next movie is,
He Came from the Woods.
Part one, starring
Tim Cooper. A cameo appearance by Bob Cooper.
Why don't we just take a look at this movie, Gene? Why don't you go and check, get it ready for us?
Yeah, I'll go.
Thank you. What do you think, Gene?
Well, firstly, that was probably one of the very best movies that I've probably seen.
I know what you mean.
One of the very best movies I saw this whole year of 1986.
It's the best movie of the summer.
It's action at its best.
Yes, action-packed.
Real interesting. It just keeps you... It keeps you going.
The characters, too.
Put it this way.
They were strong.
They're so strong and they're so
characterized. Yeah.
I just can't get the words to describe this movie.
I mean...
Put it this way. You can't even go to the bathroom. I can't go.
I could go see this movie again and again.
I tell you, people... If you ever go to this movie, don't ever get anything to drink. Because you're going to probably have to go to the bathroom. Then you're going to be stuck. You're going to have to leave. You're going to have to leave this action-packed adventure.
It's not an adventure, it's a adventure.
A horror movie, I'm sorry.
I mean,
it's action-packed.
I mean,
interesting
the
movie.
Acting, the... the... the character establishment, the action, just everything
those
is top notch.
The characters jump out at you.
I know.
I mean, it's just
they just blare at you. You know, like they clash.
I mean, the dialogue was just
unbelievably fantastic,
marvelous. Marvelous dialogue.
I give this movie a thumbs up. I give it two thumbs up.
You better believe it. Thumbs up. Thumbs up.
Yeah.
Thumbs up high.
Oh.
It came from the woods. See it. Again and again. It's a good family picture. Take your kids, because it's good.
What do you got next, Jack?
Yeah. What's on the next... That's the next movie for us, Jack. Mr. Chick. The Ghost and Mr. Chick. Why don't we just, go take a look at it. Let's see what the movie looks like.
Hey, wait a minute.
Holly, what are you doing here?
A price tag and your suit's hanging out.
That's my best card, you know it.
Reckonthal, what's up?
I got a story to answer, stuff.
You adjust that tight, little man. If there's a story, I'll handle it.
Chief, you better get somebody out of the old Simmons mansion right away. A terrible thing happened. I got the pictures and everything.
it, loser. Just calm down. Give it to me nice and slow.
Well, I was coming down the street.
Too fast.
Yeah, cool it, sport.
What happened, loser?
Well, I was coming down the street. Mr. Beck, I'm glad you're here. I got a real scoop. I got the pictures and everything.
I've been trying to get the story from Walter Cronkite here, but he just won't give.
Well, what's this all about?
I don't know. He's a cheater.
Will somebody listen to me?
What do you think about that now, Roger?
The character establishment was just unbelievable. But
that's exactly right.
Yet the plot was this thin.
The plot was deep. Deep plot. Quality. Yeah. I mean, it jumped out at you.
I said it was a thin plot. It's thin in spots.
I know, Gene, but I mean, sorry, Gene. Roger.
You're Gene.
But I know, I'm Gene, but I got mixed up in the heat of this critique. I think Don Knotts done eight.
He did an excellent job.
Perfect.
Which
job.
Brings up the nominations, Don Knotts.
I think Don Knotts, if he's got a very excellent chance of winning. Later in our show, we're going to see another great performance by Billy Trumpet. He's played by
Tom Cooper.
By Tom Cooper. This guy jumps out. And him and Don Knotts, I think, are two that are going to make, going to be possible nominees for Best Actor Award. Don Knotts does a masterful job. I mean, he lives the part.
I heard something about Gable being one of the parts, but
Gable's dead.
He's supposed to be dead. He's supposed to be one of the nominees.
We don't okay, Gable's not dead. I made a mistake. Gene Gable, I thought, is dead. Clark Gable, no.
Well, they said about Clark Gable being a nominee, but he's
Clark nothing. Gable, I don't think, is that the good actor. I'm not dead.
Tom Cooper might be the best of all
Tom
time. I think
Tom Cooper's probably one of the best young actors
of all time
to come out of Hollywood in the past 50 years.
That's pretty good.
That's
he's an excellent, and his character establishment is just unbelievable.
Let's not talk about that because we're going to see that later in the show. But let's talk about Don Knotts. This movie is scary. Here you go. It's like real scary.
It's.
What do you think about that, Roger?
It was scary in parts, and yet it was humorous.
Yeah, it was.
But I thought the plot was too thin in some spots. And it made you, sometimes a plot would just knock you right off the edge of a table like a little jar of Vicks.
Yes, pertaining to this jar of Vicks, I just knocked this over to make a literal commentary. To say that knocking this Vicks on is like...
The plot
it's
of
like
movie.
The plot of the last movie that we had.
Ghost of Mr. Chicken.
No, like the first movie. I mean, Raiders of the Lost Ark.
Yeah.
It starts out strong like this. Why don't you put it on this big spot? It starts out, you have a real solid start, and all of a sudden it drops off. That's how it does. So.
That's why we gave it a thumbs
that's
down.
That's why we gave it a thumbs down. It starts strong, like the Vicks bottle is up on the plateau, and then it drops on
you take
the carpet, yeah.
And you talk about a movie like A Cave in the Woods. It's just
straight action.
And it keeps going
excellent,
up.
Excellent. Excellent dialogue.
It keeps going up.
It starts out on a high.
It goes up.
Like, demonstrate. This Vicks bottle. It starts up like this at the start of the movie. Then as the movie goes on, it just goes higher. See?
But, well, see, the ghost of Mr. Chicken.
Yeah.
It goes up and then it drops suddenly.
I didn't see it that way, Roger. Here, I'm going to show you. Give me that big bottle. This is the ghost of Mr. Chicken. It starts out on a high plateau like it came from the woods.
Yes.
Then it levels off. Then it has a very strong ending from which it makes a sharp upper swing. That's the only thing I don't like about it. It was too dramatic. The dramatic upswing was
I have to disagree with you, Gene.
Well, why?
I thought that the plot was just too thin. I mean, the supporting actors and actresses, they just weren't, you know, they just didn't support Don Knotts.
I know they didn't,
his excellent role.
But Don Knotts was just so strong in this movie that it couldn't have been a bad movie. Final analysis.
I'm gonna have to give this movie a thumbs down, Gene.
Well, I'm gonna have to disagree with you, Roger. It's gonna be thumbs up. Thumbs up for Ghost and Mr. Chicken.
Thumbs down for Ghost and Mr. Chicken.
After that movie, we got our next movie is Griff's Carol, starring that great actor Tom Cooper, who's playing Ebenezer Scrooge. And also, what's the guy's name?
Tim Cooper.
Tim Cooper.
Yeah.
He's also playing in it, and he's got a variety of roles.
He's
Cratchit. Sort of like, yeah, he's Cratchit.
He's a utility man.
He's sort of the utility man in the movies. Because they can only get two people to do these movies because they're very low budget. So why don't we just
take a look at this.
And we'll find out.
What are you wearing my coat for? Suck it off. You probably want something this luxurious. You can't have it. You got plenty of money, you're getting paid. Why don't you use your own money? After all, I pay you $2 a week. It's about time to go, sir. Get to work. I'll tell you when it's time to go. Freeloaders, they get off and work hardly any, then they want to leave a minute early. I suppose, Kratz, you can leave now. But remember, the day after tomorrow, be here all the earlier the next morning.
Well,
that Cooper is an unbelievable actor.
I know, that guy's phenomenal.
I just
holy
unbelievable.
Awesome actor.
I haven't seen one like him.
I haven't
in
seen
years.
One come around
since
like him,
Bogart.
Since, yeah, Bogart, you know,
Stewart.
Gary Cooper.
Yeah.
Those people were, he's in their class.
He might even be ahead
he's
of
probably
him.
The class. Yeah, he's probably ahead of him in acting ability right now at this
yes.
point of his career, because he's only 20. He's 25 when he did those movies. And, you know, they didn't really get their starts until in the 30s.
Yeah.
But I think that, well, what do you think about the movie? You know, I know it was written by Charles Dickens, Christmas Carol.
It's a class
very
act.
Very beloved Christmas
it's a class
story.
Act.
It is a class movie. It's a class story written by a class person. Charles Dickens. Charlie, you know. Uncle Charlie, as I call
Charlie
him.
Charlie Dickens.
Lovingly called him.
He's
in a class.
But they brightened up the story somewhat.
I mean, they kept it going.
The
good character plot.
The character establishment was
the character
superior.
The character establishment was very
excellent.
Superior. Excellent. Excellent movie.
Yeah.
But I think that, you know, it's raining outside. I think. Yes. Well, let's back to the movie. But I think, like I said, Tom Cooper done it was a beautiful job of the character Scrooge. You know,
just like in the book.
Yeah.
You know, he just portrayed him.
In my mind, I can just picture that's the way
Scrooge was.
Scrooge was, yeah.
Yeah.
I just look at him and I say, there's Scrooge. But, you know, that's my opinion. Is that your opinion, too?
Yes, it
you
is.
You voiced
certainly.
The same opinion.
Yes.
That's what I thought. I mean, that Cratchit guy wasn't too bad. Tim Cooper?
Yeah.
I know he's done a pretty good job myself. Too. He's
a new young upcoming actor.
He's a young upcoming actor. I think he's 16, 17 years old.
Yes.
But he's doing pretty good. He's getting a lot of good tutelage.
from Tom Cooper.
Yeah. I mean, these guys know what they're doing.
See, Tim always works with Tom.
Yeah, if you ever notice, that Tom never misses his dialogue. I mean, like, you know, just...
Yes.
Be here all the earlier the next morning. That's just a stroke of genius.
Really?
I mean, in other scenes in that movie, is great, you know, when he visits the spirits.
Yes.
I mean, he just makes you think, it's a stroke of genius.
Boy, what an act.
Yeah.
It's unbelievable.
I know it is. It's super movie. Super.
Super, super. It's one of the better movies I've seen.
I'd have to say, people, this Christmas is probably going to be out at all, probably at the Riviera Theater in Des Moines here. A Christmas Carol starring Tom Cooper and Tim Cooper. It's a low-budget movie. They only cost them, $6 to make the movie, because that's how much the tape cost. But that's the way it is.
It's already made it about $60 million.
They made $220 million.
$200 million. $200 million?
Yeah, $224 million. And the first 2 weeks it made $65 million.
Yes, I know, it was unbelievable.
It's right up there with, Star Wars.
Yeah,
and Raiders,
Yeah, Christmas Carol.
Mm-hmm. Christmas Carol. Watch it. I give it
Thumbs up. Yeah.
Well, I don't... Jack?
Well, what movie
What's the next movie for us, Jack? I think it's,
It's An Invitation to Murder, another Tom Cooper classic.
Oh, brother, I can't wait.
The best movie I've ever seen.
I saw this movie 6 times. I ain't gonna tell about the movie. We're just gonna see a few scenes from the movie
Invitation to Murder.
Why don't we just take a look at them right now?
I did it again, Bill. Forget the drinks. Let's have a seat, Jim.
Okay.
Bill, what's this all about?
James, this involves a lot of money. It's a serious problem.
Darn it, James. This is serious.
That is right. Jack. He's one of my... He's an old faithful friend. He's my house there in 14 years.
Darn it, Jim! I'll do anything to get that son of a gun! Will you help me?
I don't know, Jim. I'll help you. I'll try to. I will. But I don't know if my best is good enough.
Yeah!
Marvelous job.
I cannot believe such acting. This is incredible.
I'm speechless.
That man is a genius.
I can't believe that acting. I mean, in those two scenes, that is the most exquisite, monumental, fantastic acting I've ever seen.
Yes, the last part with this house servant, unbelievable.
I mean, the emotion. I cried.
The character of Stabushment was just fantastic.
It was. I watched that movie 6 times.
I've seen it 5 times.
And I cried every time that scene came up. I was just, tears were in my eyes.
I mean,
I was just glad there was nobody there, because I was crying. I admit it.
This Cooper just meshes everything together. It's the stroke of genius.
I know, the guy is a genius.
The humor, the drama.
That's wondering where you learn this stuff. I heard he never took acting lessons
in
his life.
He's a superior actor.
unbelievable. I mean, it's that way through the whole movie. You think those are the best scenes. They are a little better. Just, a step a bit ahead. All in all, this movie loses not a boring moment in the whole movie.
Yeah, I know. There's no drop in the plot. The plot just straight ahead.
I know, it just keeps up and up.
Yes.
Well, why don't we just demonstrate here?
Here it is. This is the plateau.
This is where the ghost of Mr. Chicken was. Okay. And then it came from the woods is also in this plateau. But Imitation Murder starts out right up here. All of a sudden, it just goes straight up. There's no drop. And there's never a drop. It just goes higher and higher. It just begins fantastic. It ends up out of this world.
It's just probably one of the most
just
amazing...
Just as this big thing goes up. They don't come down like that, but it just keeps going up. That's the way in this movie is. It's just...
There's no gravity to this movie.
There's no drop. There's nothing that... I mean, people could probably go see this movie 10, 12 times. And
most every critic that I've read gave this movie 4 stars.
Well, I'm going to give it 4. 8 stars. This is a new star system.
For movies that are overwhelming.
I mean, this is overwhelming. Every critic in the whole United States and the world, in fact.
I just cannot believe
this
acting.
Rated this movie great.
Greatest movie I've ever seen, practically.
Great movie.
Yes.
Yes. I don't know.
This leaves me speechless.
I just didn't know there could anybody come up that fantastic.
I thought that kind of acting was gone.
I thought it was gone with Gary Cooper and Clark Gable, Jimmy Stewart like that.
Yeah.
It's back.
It's bad with Cooper.
We just gotta hope.
It's back. All of those actors, all of it's in Cooper.
Mm-hmm.
The Wayne.
Yeah.
The Boogie Gable.
Tom Cooper's gonna set the standards for acting excellence for years to come. What do you give this movie?
I give this a definitely...
Roger.
If I could give... I wish I could give it better. Thumbs up. I'd give it 10 thumbs up.
Yes, I'd... 10 hands. Fingers up. In fact, you know, like this is what I call it.
And it's an unbelievable movie.
Oh.
I'm going to have to go see it after we're done. I wonder if we can see that clip again after we're done.
Well, Jack, can we see that? Darn! Can't. I know, it's disappointing to you, but...
So let's get to the dog. We have to get to the dog.
Well, oh darn it, the dog of the week. Shoot. What's on the agenda today, Jack? Arsenic and old ace.
That
is pretty doggy. Doggy doo-doo, in fact, I call it... I call it the doo-doo dog of the week. Take it easy, Roger.
The doggy doo-doo.
It's worse than doggy. It's doggy doo-doo. Why don't we just...
Let's take a look at it, yeah.
Take a scene or two from...
Come on, let's roll it.
From
Jack.
This big dog. Well, wait a minute. Where is Spot the Wonder Dog?
Yeah, here he is.
Dog, come here. Get over here. Cut out. The dog of the week. Arsenic and old lace. Why don't we just take a few scenes?
Understand? How could I marry you? Me, the symbol of bachelorhood. I've sneered at every love scene in every play. I've written 4 million words against marriage. Not only hooked, but to a minister's daughter. And not only a minister's daughter, but a girl from Brooklyn. And look at you. Look at the way you look. What is that infernal contraption you've got there?
Well, that's a pen I borrowed from your aunt. You know what they say, Mortimer, something borrowed and something...
Yeah, I know that, Bromide. Something borrowed, something blue. All new. Mice and old shoes, carry over the threshold. Niagara Falls, all the silly tribe I made fun of for years. Is this what I've come to? I can't go through with it. I won't marry you, and that's that. What do you mean, yes, Mortimer? Aren't you insulted? Aren't you going to cry? Aren't you going to make a scene? I don't know Mortimer, me either. But don't you see, marriage is a superstition. It's old-fashioned.
Showed the dog of the week.
What was the dog of the week?
Arsenic and old linen.
Poison?
Linen. Is it linen?
Lace.
Jack.
What's the name of this movie?
Arsenic and old linen?
Lace.
Or lace?
Lace.
Arsenic.
Now,
lace. Arsenic and, okay, yeah, you're right, Roger. Arsenic and old lace.
Okay.
Who was in that movie?
I think it was Clark Gable. Oh, Cary Grant.
Cary Grant, yeah. Well, yeah, I suppose, you know, he had to make a living. You know, it's okay, I suppose, you know. It was a dog, though. It's truly a dog.
It truly was a dog.
Robert's joined Selig's crew. Oh, well, yeah, but, well, why don't we just, you know,
talk about the movie.
It was a dog, outright doo-doo dog.
He's a doo-doo doggy.
Yeah, dog, doggy doo-doo. It lacked any intensity. And when I went and saw it, I only sat through the first 5 or 10 minutes.
When I saw this movie, it was...
Yes, I know. It was totally ridiculous, wasn't it, Roger?
It was a ridiculous movie.
Yes.
No standards were set.
I know, it lacked any plot. I'll show you where it started. It's got it right here. Not like this fiction.
And it couldn't go any further down.
It couldn't go any further down. It was at its low. Like his dog. And dog doo-doo. Dog steps in this book. That's the way it is. You stay down here.
How's it going?
Space. Final frontier. These are the voyages of the starship Williamson Church. It's weekend mission to explore strange new happenings, to seek out new life and new problems, to boldly go where no man has gone before. Starship Williamson Church. Now let's go to the bridge where our show begins.
Stardate 1.4.77. We are around the Garcos colony. And we're going around the planet's edges to find secrets to its life forms.
Set a course for set a course for 4.544.
Yes, Captain.